One thing I've discovered is you can't be afraid to get a little wet, get right down on the ground. I'm gonna crouch low and see if I can get that just in the right spot. I really was always drawn towards nature, and anything nature I could do, that's kind of where I found that I wanted to focus my attention on.
Meet Rachel Richard Mack, a woman who has no problem getting down in the dirt to capture the perfect shot. Since retiring from teaching just before the pandemic hit, Rachel has devoted her newfound freedom to photographing the birds, woodland creatures, and beautiful vistas close to her home on Lake Scugog in Janetville, Ontario. Although Rachel snaps all of nature around her, birds get some extra attention.
They definitely do have personalities, you know, the way they cock their head a certain way, the way, you know, some of them are very, very shy. Like chickadees are not shy, especially if you've got bird feed. So I've always got a bag of bird seed in my camera bag all the time when I'm out. The cardinals are getting more comfortable with me. So I've got a pair of cardinals that live like basically are on my deck all the time, and I can get good shots of them now without them like freaking out and flying away. I'd like to train that bald eagle that I saw today, but that didn't quite happen.
Rachel says she doesn't have to go very far since she is surrounded by wildlife, but that doesn't mean she's complacent when it comes to getting the ideal photo.
I very rarely will stand up and take a picture. I am usually on my stomach or crouched down or, you know, laying in a gutter somewhere, and, you know, because that's, I'm looking at it differently. And I think that's kind of one of the philosophies I have, is that if you look at something straight on view all the time, you're never going to see it for what it might be.
One of her favorite photos comes from lying on the ground and coming face to face with a chipmunk.
If you're standing up looking down, just it's a chipmunk. But if you're at its level and you're looking at it from its point of view and it's staring back at you with this big peanut smile across its face, I was just like, that moment was amazing.
And then there was the ultimate frog portrait. Her subject was perfectly poised under the dock.
I'm leaning on the dock. I have my camera almost at water level, so I'm on my stomach. I've got the camera sitting in the water just like just above it, and I'm about this far away from this frog, and I got this great shot of it, like sharp as tack sharp, which is always what you're aiming for. But it's just this expression, and just the fact that that moment for me is, you know, my son was there holding my legs basically to make sure I didn't fall in.
And the weather doesn't have to be perfect either, it seems.
Last night I was laying on the ice, taking a picture of my crystal ball with the sunset, you know, and I'm in like full snowsuit gear because I'm actually on my stomach on the ice, and you get pretty chilly from doing that. Temperature doesn't matter. As long as you're protecting your camera gear, everything is good.
Rachel loves to share her photos daily on social media and finds that the reaction is always positive.
I get so many people who will comment or message me and say, you know, I wait for that moment where you're posting your pictures because I'm living through your experiences. And that means a lot to me. It's just, you know, let's just share the beauty of this, right? Like, I'd rather flood Facebook with pictures that people might like than anything else, right? So for me, that's what it's about.